Hi folks, this is David Kwan. I'm continuing to talk about Final Fantasy XIII 2, which is a Final Fantasy game I really, really enjoyed, which I think might be surprising to a few of you who don't like the Final Fantasy XIII game, or maybe even trilogy as overall, you know, but I was just like, whoa, Final Fantasy XIII was not liked by people, and they made a sequel, and they made another sequel, like, I have to know what these sequels are like, you know, so I had to check it for myself, and I'm glad I did, because I actually really like 13-2. And I also even like how they reference back to the original Final Fantasy 13. You can kind of read about it in the menu section, and the way they did it is pretty cool. You know, there's a woman narrating kind of the basic story, and you get to read it about it, and there's some kind of flashback kind of images in the background. It's called Premiere, Final Fantasy 13 story premieres. There's 13 chapters because, you know, Final Fantasy 13 had 13 chapters. You know, and reading, I got to kind of refresh my memory of the events of the first Final Fantasy 13 and summarize in that manner. It's like, wow, yeah, that game was a ridiculous storyline. It is so ridiculous. But it was interesting to kind of refresh my memories of Final Fantasy 13. For me, Final Fantasy 13 had a lot of strong, powerful moments. As much as I don't like that game, there are also a lot of things I do like about Final Fantasy 13. Compared to Final Fantasy 13 2, I said this in a previous video, Final Fantasy 13 has some stronger aspects. Graphics, for one. It's a more Final Fantasy 13 original game, a lot more unique settings, it's a lot more colorful, the characters, the way they interact with each other, a lot more interesting, and just so much more intriguing, and compelling too. I really enjoyed kind of the way characters grow throughout the game. Near the end, Hope especially, like I really did not like Hope in the beginning of the game, but as Hope and Lightning kind of come to bounce off each other, like Hope's desire to revenge her mom and find Snow and kill Snow, and then realizing that, you know, he's been blaming the wrong person, and Lightning kind of being like, I don't need anyone, because if I'm only going to hurt other people by other people depending on me, but then Hope is coming to depend on her, and that relationship bounces back and forth. Like, the relationships that happen in Final Fantasy 13 are great. And even as a group, there's moments when they realize, like, the things that we're doing, we're branded as a terrorist group. But maybe they're right. We are a terrorist group that are just kind of killing everything in our path because we're branded as terrorists, and Lightning's like, well, we have no choice but to go forward. But then Snow is, you know, it's really powerful, like those kind of moments that happen when, you know, the characters question themselves. And the game story questions itself also. And there's players involved, the Falci, and there's the question about fate and destiny kind of gets really interwoven in there. And that's really powerful. I really like that a lot. So I think those two things are really kind of the things the original game is much better than about the sequel of Final Fantasy 13 2. But almost everything else I want to say. Oh, and the music. Music of Final Fantasy 13 is fantastic. And the music of Final Fantasy 13 2 is fantastic as well. Although, I think it's going to have. Music of Final Fantasy 13 2 is a lot more controversial. There are songs with lyrics. There are songs that there is a singer in the background. It's not all instrumental. The chocobo music, the metal chocobo music, that's like da 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 da. I think that's controversial as well. I think it's hilarious, but it is kind of maybe some people will think this is not an appropriate music to be playing as you're riding a chocobo. but it's there's a lot of cheese element to Final Fantasy 13 too. But some of the music I was really kind of like, wow, like Yule's theme, da da da. Da 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 na na na. Like, it's so beautiful when it happens, like in the ending sequence, when you go 700 years into the future, where Noel is from, and you're walking around following Noel's footsteps, and Noel doesn't know that Sarah is there, And it's a really red world. I'm kind of starting to talk about Final Fantasy 13 and like the near ending part. Sorry about that. But all this to say, music is fantastic. So I, of the music, of the soundtrack of the three games, I think Final Fantasy 13 2 is probably my favorite because it's more diverse. There's a lot more unique tracks. I'm not as bothered by the songs having lyrics. There's being singers in the background. I think that's okay. They're not my favorite, but there are some pieces in here that are just so powerful. The soundtrack is so great. Although, I don't know, original soundtrack of Final Fantasy 13 was really great too. A lot of Final Fantasy 13 2 is a remix of the soundtrack of 13, but it just sounds so good. I think it's done a lot better. Anyway, let's kind of start delving into some of the main topics to talk about in Final Fantasy 13 2. Let's start with the very beginning. So, the three Final Fantasy 13 games, they do this now. You start the game, and there is this intro cutscene. There's the music, the main theme music playing in the background, and it's just the introduction cutscene of the game. When you start playing the game, it's going to play, but without the dialogue. And Final Fantasy 13 2 is an amazing sequence of this grand battle between Lightning and Caius. And Lightning controls this army of monsters, and Caius has this power of the chaos of Etro. And with like a lot of purple beams and energy beams and energy waves, it's just an incredible battle, and you get the sense that they've been fighting for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. It is so great. And then when you hit the game, the game starts with that cutscene, but now with dialogue between Lightning and Caius. But it's still really great to see again with dialogue. And then Noel is brought in, and the game begins with the gameplay. The gameplay in the beginning is very basic. It's very tutorial. It's just like hit X on this and this, and choose this attack and that attack by pressing X and whatnot. So it's very basic, but it's action-packed. It's really awesome. It really sets the tone for the game really well. I think even this game, from the beginning, I was just like, okay, I'm into it. I'm buying this. Not that I already have the game, but I mean, I'm buying into this whatever the game is kind of presenting to me is what I meant. You know, I'm captivated, I'm intrigued, I'm in the universe of the game already. You know, so I think Final Fantasy 13 2 did a great job of that. It has, from at least in the beginning part, and near the end part, excellent pacing. In the middle is where the pacing is kind of but I think that's okay because the game kind of, it's like, okay, here is the settings and the times that you can go to. Go explore. The game has a lot of emphasis on exploration, which is in total contrast to Final Fantasy 13, which is great. Because, you know, that was one of the main criticisms of 13, that it's so linear. It's a hallway simulator, you know, and 13.2 is not. It's not a hallway simulator. It's like, you can go here and there. You can change. There's all these things to collect when you go there. There's this side quest to do. There's this side quest to do. It is a, you know, very impressive game in that regard. It's a very open-ended game. But I think it is, that's why there's only very few settings. It's not as colorful as 13 original. See, that's the main advantage of a linear game, is that the game can kind of design amazing set pieces around and kind of really guide you to these powerful moments. And 13.2 is not able to do a good job of that. But that's okay, because it's a fun game to kind of explore and to see and to check out. So that's what I really liked. And again, this video is running long, so I'll continue talking about Final Fantasy 13.2 in the next video.